This is Optimal Living Daily, episode 149, Loving What I Used to Hate and My Loss by Derek Sivers of Sivers.org.
Get ready to maximize your potential with Optimal Living Daily, the podcast that brings you the best in personal development and productivity every day of the week. Your optimal life awaits. Now here's your host, Justin Mollick.
Hello, hello, and welcome to Optimal Living Daily with your host, me, Justin Mollick, the guy who's forcing himself to read out loud every single day on this podcast. And I appreciate you listening. Really, it means a lot. And I want to give back to you, actually. Yes, you listening right now. Do you have a blog or a product or service that other OLD listeners would benefit from? Or do you have some words that you want to share with this group? I've decided to start a blog section on the companion site of this podcast, and I'm taking guest posts right now. So if you're interested in sharing something valuable and maybe spreading the word about yourself or your business in the process, and possibly having the post read right here on the podcast for even more exposure, come by oldpodcast.com and send me a message, and I can give you details on what exactly I'm looking for. And it's Silver Sunday today, but like I mentioned last week, I'm kind of running low on posts of his that are the right length and content for this podcast, so maybe Sunday will be the day that I'll start sharing some of your guest posts from the Optimal Living Daily blog. That could be really cool if we could pull it off together. And I think that's enough of an intro, so for now, let's jump right into Silver Sunday and start optimizing your life. Loving What I Used to Hate by Derek Sivers of Sivers.org. From now on, when I say I hate something, remind me to add today to the sentence. Here's why. Tom Waits. The first time I heard Tom Waits was a performance on David Letterman. I hated it. I hated it passionately. I complained to my friend that it was the worst thing I'd ever heard, and it must be some kind of joke. The second time I heard Tom Waits was a year later, when my roommate played me Singapore, and I hated it just as much. I still thought it must be some kind of in-joke. Maybe it's a dare, like Hauker. Someone wouldn't actually listen to this for pleasure, would they? The third time I heard Tom Waits was It's All Right With Me, and suddenly I got it. Maybe it's because it's a cover, or maybe I was sick of all normal music that day, but his American exotic theatrical junkyard sound was just what I needed. Then I bought the great Rain Dogs album, and it's one of my favorite albums of all time, especially Tango Till They're Sore, which I hated before and now love the most. Indonesia. The best TEDx conference I've ever been to was in Jakarta, Indonesia. From the cross-gender dancer to a leader of games, I got such an overwhelming dose of Indonesian talent, culture, and pride that day that a part of me will forever feel Indonesian, or at least a big fan. A week later, I had a laugh when I suddenly remembered that I used to hate Indonesia. Why? Because in my old company, CD Baby, whenever we get a big order from Indonesia and ship the CDs across the world, the credit card company would contact me months later to tell me that order was placed with a stolen credit card. Every time it was Indonesia. Small orders, big orders, every one of them was always credit card fraud. I lost thousands of dollars before I finally had to block all Indonesian visitors to cdbaby.com and silently delete any orders with an Indonesia shipping address. I remember cursing that quote-unquote nation of thieves and its horrible inhabitants. I'm sure at the time you couldn't have paid me to go to that awful place. Oops, wrong. Once I got to know it, I loved it. Weightlifting. Ever since high school, when I was solidly in the quote-unquote freaks category, I've made fun of people who spend a lot of time at the gym lifting weights. Stupid jocks mindlessly lifting pieces of metal. A few years ago, some people I know all recommended old-fashioned barbell training as a great all-around fitness habit. I tried it, and they were right. I love it. 3 times a week, I'm in the gym for only 30 minutes doing squats and deadlifts. I have to smile thinking what my former self would say, but the former self is not always right. We don't need to preserve our first opinions as if they are a pure, untarnished, true nature. They're often just ignorance or inexperience. Now when I catch myself saying that I hate or love something, I try to remember to add today to the end of the sentence. Opinions are likely to change at any time, but are much harder to change if you've carved out your self-identity, declaring, quote, this is what I love, that is what I hate, unquote. Though I'm happy to say, this is what I hate or love today. My Loss by Derek Sivers of Sivers.org. In 1 year, 2007, my wife divorced me and took my life savings. 90% of my company was no longer mine on a technicality. My apartment was destroyed, so I slept and showered in the warehouse. All my employees, led by my good friend and VP, led a mutiny against me. I never returned and never saw them again. I invested everything I had left in a very conservative fund, which fell 50% immediately and never came back. I invested everything I had left in a different conservative fund, which also fell 50% and never came back. The woman I was madly in love with married the guy she would always complain to me about. 2 weeks after that year ended, three companies called asking if I wanted to sell my company. Though I had said no to that question for 10 years, this time I said yes. I had messed up so bad, I had to walk away. I had done everything wrong and needed to cleanse myself of all those bad decisions. I needed to take some time to learn from my mistakes and replace my thoughts with new ones. A self-made back to schooling. I look back at that year and know it won't get much worse. If I can handle that, I can handle anything. The company's sale was announced. The first time someone said congratulations, I said, for what? I messed up so bad I lost my baby. That's nothing to congratulate. And for future congratulations, I just shrug. We all underestimate our ability to massively change our life when it's gone off track. Say no where you used to say yes. Say yes where you used to say no. Do the thing that scares you the most, then get up and go. For those of you considering a massive change, I can tell you from experience, it's awesome here on the other side. You just listened to the post titled Loving What I Used to Hate and My Loss by Derek Sivers of Sivers.org. So there you have it, two shorter posts from Derek Sivers. And like I mentioned before, I might not be able to keep Sivers Sunday going for much longer because of the amount of content I've already read here on the podcast. But I'm thinking about reading guest posts from you if they can offer high-value content to the listeners of this show. So if that's something you're interested in, come by oldpodcast.com and get in touch with me. And that's all I got for today. I'll be back tomorrow with the usual Minimalist Monday. So I'll see you there where your optimal life awaits.
Hey, this is Dan from the Optimal Finance Daily podcast, which is a lot like this show, except more focused on personal finance. Justin handpicks the best posts he can find from blogs and authors like Ramit Sethi, Mr. Money Mustache, and more, and I read them to you 5 days a week. So if you enjoy this podcast, come on over and subscribe to Optimal Finance Daily too. And together, we'll optimize your financial life.
You've been listening to Optimal Living Daily. Be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on each new episode and head to oldpodcast.com. That's oldpodcast.com for a free gift as well as more actionable tips and resources to help you maximize your potential. Thanks for joining us, and remember, your optimal life awaits.